Good evening, my friends. Today, I have come with a very interesting topic. I got many requests from students regarding this topic. Yes, how to crack CMA in first attempt and as well as how to get job in PSUs or government organization. First of all, I would like to introduce myself. As you know, myself CMA Shilpa Banerjee, and I have completed CMA within 3 years. Today, I will share with you the solutions due to which I felt that I was unable to crack CMA final in first attempt. I find 3 problems were there: proper guideline, proper planning, and where there is no proper guideline and proper planning, there is no proper action. So at first, I would like to introduce you about a cost accountant and its scope. So cost accountants are in great demand in government sector, private sector, banking and finance sector, developmental agencies, education sector, training and research sector, as well as service and public utility sectors, and many more. And secondly, which position a CMA can hold? Let's see. So, the CMA may hold top management positions in public and private sectors in enterprises, like he can be the chairman come managing director, or he can be only the managing director, finance director of a company, finance controller, chief financial officer, which is often called a CFO, cost controller, marketing manager, and chief internal auditor, and other likewise important positions. So it's very much clear that a CMA has the ability to hold top positions in a company. As we can see, there are mainly 2 wings open for a CMA. First one, he or she can select for a job in big companies, or he or she can become independent, that is, may involve himself or herself in practice. During his tenure of independent practice, he has a great demand in private and public companies, large, medium and small scale undertakings, partnership and proprietary concerns, industrial, commercial and service undertakings, and many more. Now, the important question I would like to keep in front of you, my friends. For example, you have 6 doors in front of you and you have only 1 key. You can enter in any of these doors, but provided the key should unlock that particular door. So it's my suggestion, there are many other professions to choose via commerce. But at first analyze and then only decide which profession to choose. Please don't loiter yourself here and there. So I am now assuming that you have chosen the door of CMA. There are 2 gateways to get enrolled yourself into CMA intermediate course. First one, you have to clear foundation after plus 2 examination, or you have to clear your graduation pertaining to a certain discipline. And for more, just visit www.icmai.in. I am assuming here that you have done either of the 2 and enrolled yourself into CMA Intermediate. Here there are a bunch of 8 papers, each group containing 4 papers, which makes 2 groups. Now, sometimes due to study pressure, students often decide to give a single group. Now first let me introduce with the papers. It's financial accounting, that is accountancy part, law and ethics, direct taxation about the income tax and all, cost accounting, which will cover the entire cost, operations management and strategic management, cost and management accounting and financial management. In direct taxation, which contains two wings, that is GST as well as the Customs Act, company accounts and audit. Now, here due to study pressure, students often decide to give a single group, what I was saying. Here first we will assume that you are giving a single group. So here passing criteria is minimum 50% in whole group. That is, there are 400 marks of 100 marks each paper. So here you have to get at least 200 out of 400 marks. And minimum 40% in each paper. That is 40 marks out of 100 marks. So in the first one, in the first case, it's total you have got 200 marks. So here the first point getting 50% is satisfied. And here you have got a minimum of 40% marks in each paper also. Yes, second point also satisfied. So you have passed in the first case. Now you may fail in two ways. In the second case, you have got 199, that is below 50%. So first condition failed. But you have got minimum 40%. In each paper, so you have already achieved 40%, but since you cannot satisfy both the conditions, you failed in this group. But you got exemption in cost accounting paper because you got 64. Now just take into mind that you have to get minimum 60% in each paper, or in a particular paper, that paper you don't have to attempt for 3 terms, so it is beneficial for you. Now in the third case, in group you have got 207, that is above 50%, but you have got 39 in law, below 40% in a paper. Then also you failed. Now please note carefully advantages of giving both groups. In first case, you have passed both the groups. In group 1, total marks is 179. Yes, then also pass. Because when you are giving the both groups together, then total 8 papers are there. And taking the 8 papers, you need to get 50% minimum, that is 400 out of 800. And second condition of 40% remaining the same. Here, maybe you got 179 in group 1, but you got 225 in group 2, which total makes 404, that is above 50%. First condition satisfied since minimum 40% in each paper, and second condition also satisfied. So you have passed the intermediate. But in second case, by giving both the groups, you can pass a single group also. You can see in group 1 it's 176 and group 2 it's 225. So total makes it 401. You have satisfied the first condition, but you got 39 in law. So you missed second condition. So here you will pass group 2 only, as it satisfies both the conditions. So this is the benefit of giving both the groups. Now I will come with you some of the important things. Though we have listened many times, but please realize how much they are important. Study in a group. Take minimum of 3 friends. What are the benefits? We know that we often make promise to ourselves to complete our daily study routine. But again, after 2 to 3 days we fail. Now when a group, you will make promise plus something, that is commitment, that we should clear CMA, yes, in first attempt. You can achieve it very easily. Secondly, motivation. It plays a very important role. If you need alone 10 to 12 hours, you just feel very bored to follow just a monotonous routine. But in a group, each one of you will motivate each other. Next, divide the chapters among the members of that group. So in first day, in just one day, you can complete more chapters of different subjects, and your communication skill development will increase day by day, which is also very important to crack interview. So why late? Just begin from intermediate level itself. And then you can follow a test routine, that is taking tests on different subjects on weekly or monthly basis. Next, now, please just pay your attention. If you want to crack PSU after becoming CMA, Just include a 100 marks paper for yourself or in your group. On regular basis, practice these things. General knowledge. Static, that is location of different rivers, different national parks, sanctuaries, etc. as well as current affairs, what is going on nowadays. You may follow economic times or other applications in mobile phone, which is easily available. For mathematics, practice 8, 9, 10 maths from your books. English and reasoning. For more details, you can search for a PSU written examination question paper and find the details. But my point is, start from intermediate yourself. Now, the important points. Often, it has been seen that students just anyhow want to pass. But after during that interview, we face a lot of problems. So, you should make a clear knowledge about Ind AS, GST and cost and management accounting, financial management, here working capital, cash flow, etc. As well as, please go through the study material thoroughly. You can do self-study on law and ethics. GST is really very well explained in study material. You can go through it, or else you can buy pen drives and books according to your best knowledge is concerned. Now just realized, yes, you have cleared intermediate. Now it's time to attend for final. So just maintain the same things I have covered for inter. So now the question is, why CMA? Many students ask me, remain confused, which course is better to do. See, all the courses have their own advantages. As the name of the courses are different, the scope, work, concepts are also very different. I am just giving my personal analysis. It may differ from person to person. Minimum 6-month training is required for satisfying the criteria to sit for final examination. So these 6 months, utilize it very wisely. Here, if you lack practical knowledge, I can say difficulties will be knocking at your door. If your chapter just suggests any organization for training, please join that, else continue with any firm. Now, I am assuming that you have cracked CMA within 3 years. Then minimum salary package, I am telling that very minimum is 2.4 to 3 lakhs per annum, that is 20,000 to 25,000 per month. Just take 2 to 3 years of experience, your minimum package will become 6 to 8 lakhs per annum, that is 50,000 or more per month. So, just it will take only 5 to 6 years of your entire life to earn ever 50,000 minimum. So, I think it's a really a great opportunity, my friends, and you should go with it. So, now whatever I have given suggestion, that is completely from my viewpoint, and it may differ from person to person. I wish you all the very best and goodbye.